Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to another video. Today I have a Bath & Body Works, a little mini haul for you. I only have 4 candles. I did a major pause on buying candles because when I know I can get something for a certain price, I have a really hard time paying full price. And I've sort of been spoiled into getting the Bath & Body Works candles for around $10, even though I think, yeah, so they're now up to $24.50. I think full price they used to be $19.99, so they keep raising them slightly, which I understand because they're very popular. They have very cute packaging, and every season they switch up the scents, and so they've become this White Barn Candle Company, which is, I believe, the candle brand that Bath & Body Works makes. They just, you know, are able to raise the price point, and I get it because when people were using coupons, you're pretty much getting them 50% off. So because I got spoiled into that price point for so long, I have a problem not getting them for around that price. Usually Black Friday is when I go kind of ape bonkers with my checkout cart, because I just know that like those are gonna be the lowest you'll ever find them for legit the entire year. So anyway, I was kind of like waiting and waiting and waiting for a sale, and I was like, everybody's home and like online shopping, like why aren't they like giving us a coupon or putting the candles on sale? They kept having the little mini ones 2 for $20, and I was like, no, that's not a good deal. They're like half the size. So I kept waiting and waiting and waiting, and then it hit me. Duh, Rachel, everybody's home on quarantine. They're probably buying candles because like you want to make your surroundings as comfortable and smelling nice as possible. And they probably had such amazing sales. Why would you put something on sale if the sales are doing well? That's just like against the rules of marketing. So, you know, I figured that they just weren't giving us a good sale on these because they didn't really need to discount them. People are still buying them at full price, but not me. I'm too cheap. So, anyway, that's kind of why I did a pause. And you guys might have seen, if you follow me on Instagram, in my stories like a couple weeks back, I got 2 different candle scents from Target. One was called Blue Lavender. It smelled like really cozy and warm. And the other one was called actually Cozy Nights. Both smelled amazing, but I just have to say that there's just no other candles that I've found, even Yankee Candle. There's no candles that I've found that are quite, I don't want to say pungent because that almost sounds bad, but like they don't give off the smell quite the same as these White Barn. They last forever. The 3 wicks that they have burn really evenly, and for the price point, you just can't beat the candles from Bath & Body Works. So without further ado, I just wanted to kind of give you guys why I'm so obsessed with their candles. I really think that they have the best smells. When I light a candle from Bath & Body Works, my entire room within a matter of like 10 minutes will smell like it. Even when I lit my Target candles, they smelled really good, but like I had to put my nose like right up to even remotely smell the candle. So they just weren't the same. I was really missing my candles. So I finally got them $10 off. So they weren't quite as low as my $10 candles, you know, that I used to get. Again, Black Friday, hands down, lowest candle prices. They're around $8 if you can hold out until then. But I found them $10 off. So instead of $24.50, they're $14.50 each. So I was like, okay, fine. So I tried to behave myself because A, I'm moving. B, they weren't like as low as I typically like them. So I just got a couple. So I'm just gonna take you through the 4 that I got. This one was a newer one. I'm gonna try and put it back because it's really light outside, so it's kind of hard to see. But this one is the Palo Santo scent. It smells like incense. If you've ever burned Palo Santo, you know exactly what this smells like. It smells kind of like a very masculine cologne, but very spa-like, very crisp and clean, and definitely a little herbal, But like, okay, so I hate sage. When someone burns sage, I legit can throw up. Like one of the girls that I used to work with at Lime Crime would burn sage all the time, and I used to get so mad. I'm like, A, this is not your private living room to just burn the stuff whenever you want. B, people were getting sick. It was so pungent. It smelled like dirty skunk. It was the worst smell I've ever smelled. So sorry for all you spiritual people out there. I just don't get the burning of sage. I don't believe it gets rid of evil spirits or cleanses the air or whatever you guys think it does. I think it's ridiculous. But I know some people burn it for that reason. But if you're going to burn anything and you don't want to offend noses around you, Palo Santo, my yoga teacher used to burn Palo Santo instead of sage. This is definitely a little more easy on the nose. And it just smells very, what's the word? Cleansing. So the notes in this one are Palo Santo wood, warm amber, soft musk with essential oils. So I find all of those musky smells are smells that I really gravitate towards. They're kind of like those sexy, smoky smells. So if you like incense and you like the smell of Palo Santo burning, the candle is amazing. And I don't know if you guys can see it, it's not picking up so well on screen, but this is the most beautiful, like iridescent, kind of like a rainbow hue. The color is just beautiful. Again, I think the camera's kind of washing it out, but so nice. So that was my first candle. Let me pick up my box here. Okay. Next one we have here, and what I also love is like their candles would sometimes break. They have this new packaging where the bottom, it doesn't quite touch the bottom, so it's got like, you know, that. And then on top they fold it in, and I find that almost like since they've been sending them like this, almost none of my candles break. So I really like the new packaging. I was gonna take them out, and I was like, girl, you're moving. You don't want them to break. Just leave them in this. So next one I have, and again, some of these are new scents for me, so I kind of wanted to take you guys through them because some of the ones I bought I really like, and others I'm like. So this one is from their aromatherapy line. I've purchased a couple of scents from their aromatherapy line before. And it said this one was new, and I was like, ooh, rosemary's kind of herbal, and then peppermint, like I know I'll love that. So I bought this one, but truth be told, I don't really love the smell of it. I'll probably still burn it. Sean liked it. He said he thought it smelled nice, but it's for clarity. So I was like, oh, as I'm working or as I'm sending out emails and stuff, as I'm packing, I'll put this on and it should be nice, but I can't really put a finger on what I don't like about it. I think it's just the combination. I definitely smell the peppermint, but something, and I like the smell of rosemary, but maybe just combined, I don't know. Maybe it will be different as I'm burning it. Sometimes once you burn it could smell a little different, but I'll probably use this up, but I wouldn't recommend. This one just says aromatherapy clarity, peppermint promotes concentration, and then rosemary reduces emotional strain. Can't we all use a little of that right now? So, anyway, that is the next one, clarity. And I purchased other ones from them before, like the relaxation, sleep. I forget the other ones, but I do like several other of the scents in their aromatherapy line. I just think that one to me, the combo's like a little funky. Okay, next up, what is this one? Oh, this one is a classic Rachel. I buy this every summer. This is probably one of my favorite summer scents. I go back to it time and time again. This is the scent Endless Weekend. It's like fruity but fresh. I don't know. Something about this one, I just am obsessed with it. So the fragrance notes in this are fresh summer mandarin, sun-kissed magnolia, blue coconut water with essential oils. So again, there's just something so, refreshing and summery and light and fun. I love this one. This one is definitely like a crowd pleaser. If you're like, I don't know what kind of scent to start with, this is a good one. Almost everybody that comes over that I burn at, they're not like, oh, that's a little funky. They're always like, wow, it smells amazing in here. What candle do you have going? So highly recommend that one. And then last but not least, you guys, I saved the cutest for last because this one is like, oh my gosh, just so cute. So it's pink and green. This one, like, it doesn't get any summery. They actually put out really pretty candles for summer. A lot of them have like floral patterns and design. I think they really went all out with some of their patterns. I mean, who would not want this sitting in their living room or bedroom, especially if you live in like a tropical place? Oh my gosh, so cute. So this one is Coco Cabana. I've never seen them do this before. Like, actually, most of the candle is always like clear. So I thought that that was really cute that they have like a green cover and then green wax. It just smells coconutty. Yeah, coconutty. But there's something else in here, kind of smoky too. Oh, I knew it. See, I can always pick up when there's like musk or smoky. So I was gonna say it smells sweet, but not overly sweet. Like some of the, I love coconut, so I bought another coconut one once. I want to say it was called like coconut snowflake. It was just too sweet. Like I was sitting there watching TV around the holiday and I was like, I feel like I have a headache from this candle. So whenever you mix like a sweet with like either a floral or sweet with fresh or sweet with smoke, you get like a really well-balanced candle. Now I'm the candle pro. So this one has coconut cream, vanilla, sandalwood, hint of pineapple with essential oil. So I definitely smell that sandalwood smell. It's kind of got like a little smoke to it. I just love it. So I can't wait. I'm going to bring this to Florida. I'm not burning this a second before I get there because A, this is going to look super cute in my bedroom. And now that I'm going to be a Florida girl, I'm going to make my room just as pretty and like tropical. So that will for sure be on my dresser. So that is it, you guys. Four candles. I still managed to spend like $60 and change. Did I find a coupon code? Yeah, I think I found a coupon code for free shipping for those. So I wound up just paying like the $14.50 times four plus tax. But I love the majority of my haul. I'm pretty happy with it, with the exception of maybe that rosemary peppermint. But again, I'll still get through it. Maybe it will smell better once I start actually burning it. But I think that's it. That's all I wanted to tell you guys for today's Bath & Body Works little mini haul. Tell me any summer scents that you guys are currently burning that you think are amazing and that I need to get my hands on. If not, I will see you guys all in my next video and talk to you soon. Bye.